Jesus loves me. 4 and 5, he's by my side. 6 and 7, he's the way to heaven. 8, 9, 10, I sing it again. I can always count on him. I can always count on Jesus. I can always count on Jesus.
Everybody.
What's up, friends?
Welcome back to the Church Kid Show.
Welcome back. Charles, I have decided that I'm only going to speak in cheesy Hallmark friendship quotes for the rest of the day.
No thank you.
A friend can make you smile even when she's not around.
This is my worst nightmare, yes. Why is this happening?
A faithful friend is the medicine of life.
Please stop. Tracy, why are you doing this?
Well, because this is our last week talking about who God is and what it looks like to have a relationship with Him.
Yes, that's all true, but it still doesn't tell me why you're talking in Hallmark quotes all the time.
Because God is our friend, and these quotes talk about friendship, and also because I love Hallmark Christmas movies.
So basically, you're doing this for no reason.
A best friend, Charles, is someone who, when they don't understand, they still understand.
Wow, so deep. Yeah, I definitely don't understand.
All right, fine. I'll stop with the friendship quote.
Thank you. Now I can finally get on with what I have planned for the day.
Okay, what do you have planned for the day, Charles?
Well.
Oh, no!
I like to call this segment of the Church Kids Show making Tracy play video games because she has absolutely no idea what she's doing, and it's hilarious.
No, perfect.
Today, we will be playing a game called Moving Out. This is where you pick some kind of weird characters and you really recklessly move out of home.
Great.
Onto a truck.
Can't wait.
It's genius.
Do we like work against each other or working together?
We work together.
Oh, I like, that's perfect. It's a friendship
game. It is.
You play
no
as
Hallmark,
friends.
No Hallmark quotes.
Friendship, the medicine of life and all good things.
Men. Okay, so first thing you gotta do is pick your character. So you're on this one. Yep.
Cute! A unicorn!
Can I kind of want to be a toaster. No, I definitely want to be.
This is such a random.
I want to be the bird.
Well, obviously, I'm gonna be the unicorn. What is that that she's standing on? Some sort of like cart? I don't understand what's happening.
So that's a wheelchair, actually.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm picking that.
Okay, I'm putting a fish on my head. You got the unicorn, the snazzy wheelchair, and the pineapple, and I'm the bird with the fish.
I'm so excited.
I'm gonna take Tracy through training really quick. It takes a minute, and just so she knows the controls, and we'll be right back. All right, here we go. We're gonna go to the first house.
Here we go.
We're gonna go to Holly's home. Preface, this is like level one. It's like the easiest house.
Okay, well, you don't have to rub it in. That I'm probably gonna be horrible.
No, that's why I wanted you to know to be like, this is the easy one.
No! Okay. I can't even move.
All right, here we go. Okay, let's go into the front door. Okay, let's grab these little things right next to you. Yep, just grab
little
them.
Little things.
Grab them and go.
I forget how to grab already.
One of the triggers. No, let go. I got that one. Get the other stuff.
I thought we had to help each other.
We do, but no, don't grab that. Grab the small items, like the TV.
What small? Okay.
All the little things.
Okay, I'm grabbing it. Now what do I do?
Yeah, come out the front door. Hurry. We're time.
I can't. Okay, wait, and then I bring it up here, and then I let go.
Yep, I'm going through the window. Woo!
Oh, I didn't know you could do that. You didn't tell me I could do that.
Grab the other side of the couch.
Oh, okay, now.
Go over to it, but I don't, you don't hold it, just grab when you get there.
I promise you what I say.
No, the other side. You have to get perfectly the other side. To throw it out the window, yes. Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Here we go. Ready? Mm-hmm. Hold Y. Yes! Good job. I'm just going to start throwing things out the window.
Okay.
Get them on the truck.
I don't understand how you grab things so quickly. I can't even tell if I have anything in my hands.
You don't. grab a little toaster on the kitchen
counter.
I'm trying!
Oh, so it's just the stuff that's like...
It's glowing, it's flashing.
Glowing.
Yeah, good. Now you can jump out the... Oh, good. Oh, you missed it.
How did I miss? I like how
Let's go out the front door. Oh. Okay, we're going to toss it. So actually get... Here. Keep moving with me.
I don't know down, which way you're moving.
Down here. Okay. Down here. And then I'm going to line up right here. Hold Y. And we're gonna toss it! Yeah!
Man, Holly, you need all this stuff moved? You're not leaving anything behind? Have a garage sale, girlfriend.
You have a grill.
I do.
Yeah, here, I'll help you throw it.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you got it. Go. Go, and I'm gonna actually help you throw it on. Oh, no, actually, it's okay.
I'm stuck.
Okay, just jump. Oh, no, you put it back. Here. No!
She doesn't need your toilet paper.
Okay.
She takes her lawn chair and not her toilet paper.
We need this to, okay, got this on here.
I'm by the bed. I'm ready to move it.
Why use the front door when I can use the window?
Okay
ready? Hold Y. Uh-huh. There it goes.
Bye, bed.
Oh my gosh, we're getting bronze. Okay, I'm gonna let go. We're gonna toss this thing over there because there's no room.
Sounds good.
Scoot over, okay. Y, yes. Oh, there's still a chair.
Where?
Right here.
Oh, that the table fell off.
Oh my gosh, no! Oh no! Get everything on. Okay, we gotta throw it all. Okay, we have to throw all of it. Come over here. Okay. Hold Y. Mm-hmm. Throw it. There we go. Next. Okay, grab this with me. On the other side. On the other side.
It's a circle. How do I know?
Other side. Do your best. Good job. It's not the other side.
Are you serious?
Yes. We're almost out of time. Come on. Okay. Yes. Okay. Scoot a little bit forward. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now hold Y. Yes.
Yes.
Woo.
You are moved, Holly girl.
Well done, Tracy.
Woo.
Well done.
Wow.
Well done.
My heart is racing. That was very stressful. Woo. Okay. Well, to be honest, that was actually pretty fun and a great way to end the month of February.
We wish all of you could play this game with us, but let's check in with the East Side and see what game they have for us today.
Lord, does that count? Let's go!
What's up, church kids? It's me, Teacher Jeremias, back with another very fun game that I like to call a lean nigga tower of a cups. This game is a race to stack your cups with the ping pong balls inside. Now let me explain. To play the game, you're gonna start off by having a cup on the table in front of you. Your goal is to bounce the ping pong ball into that cup. Then you can place a piece of cardstock paper on top of that cup and put another cup on top. Your goal is to keep on doing that 4 times until you build the whole tower. The first person to build the leaning tower of a cups in under 60 seconds or before your opponent wins the game.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
So we know the love that God has for us, and we trust that love. God is love, God is love, got it, God is love. Everyone who lives in love lives in God, and God lives in them. 1 John 4:16 again. So we know the love that God has for us, and we trust that love. God is love, God is love, got it, God is love. God is love. Everyone who lives in love lives in God, and God lives in them. 1 John 4:16, here we go. I got love for the people, whether lost or found, friends or enemies, I give love to all around. You can love someone you don't like, let them try a new bite. Love can take a hardened heart, make it soft and let it light. I can do something nice for someone that I wanted to fight before. More good things to pour, love gives you wings, so I'm about to soar. Love is not a feeling, it's an action with more meaning than the greatest thing you could imagine. Better than a kind of pageant. Live in love, then you live in God. God is love. Give him all kabod.
Glory
from above, unconditional. Yeah. Love is why Jesus saved my soul. Again, when you live in love, then you live in God.
Live in God, live in God.
God is love. Give him all kabod.
Glory
from above, unconditional. Love is why Jesus saved my soul. So we know that love that God has for us, and we trust that love. Yeah. God is love. God is love.
Got it.
God is love. Everyone who lives in love lives in God, and God lives in them. 1 John 4:16 again. So we know the love that God has for us, and we trust that love. God is love. God is love.
Got it.
God is love. We trust it. Everyone who lives in love lives in God, and God lives in them. 1 John 4:16. That's it.
This is our last week talking all about who God is.
God is our perfect Heavenly Father, the creator of all things, and he cares so much about you.
Remember our faith declaration this month is, I am deeply loved by God.
As you continue on throughout this year and face whatever challenges that come your way in 2022, remember that God loves you so much and is there for you through all of it.
I cannot wait to jump into our final lesson of the month. It's going to be so great.
Roll it.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Set go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do. On a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Oh. Sweet sugary smiles. Hi, friends. I'm getting ready to go on a Bible adventure. Shake your hands high in the sky if you want to come with me. Woohoo! Great, then let's put on our adventure bags. Shine, my star friend, sent me a question. Why does God's Holy Spirit live in you? I hope he's here soon to help me find the answer.
Hi, Emily. Have you packed your picture passes yet?
No, but I got your question. Why does God's Holy Spirit live in you? God is really, really big. I don't know why he would want to live in me. Which picture passes will help me shine?
I'll give you hints to help you out. Friends, will you help too?
Great! Then let's look at our picture passes. Wow!
The first picture pass is something you give someone on their birthday.
Oh, what is it, friends? Oh, we picked the gift, is that it?
Yes, open your adventure bag and pack the gift.
Hot diggity dog, I love presents.
Me too, here's the next hint. It's a place to live. It has a roof, a door, and windows.
Which do you think it is, friends?
That's right, it's a house.
Then I'm going to put the house picture pass in my adventure bag.
One more. It's got glass on it, so you have to be careful. When you look at it, you can see yourself.
What do you think it is, friends? Oh! We picked the mirror! Oh! Let's zip our adventure bag together!
Oh! Now it's time to fly!
Come on, let's go! We have a gift, a house, a mirror. Shine, how do these picture passes show me the reason God wants His Holy Spirit to live in me?
I have the perfect story from the book of Acts in the Bible.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
God's wonderful gift.
Do you think the story is about getting presents?
Let's watch it to find out.
Jews from all over the world were in Jerusalem for the Feast of Pentecost. Jesus' followers were there too. They gathered together, waiting for the gift Jesus had promised them. In the middle of the festival, God's gift arrived. It began with a sound. A sound like a howling wind that filled the house where they were waiting. Next, something that looked like fire settled on each one of them. Then, God's Holy Spirit filled everyone in the room, and He gave them power to speak different languages. Jews from other parts of the world heard them and were amazed. "These people are speaking our languages," they said, "and proclaiming the wonderful things God has done." "This is God's gift," Peter explained. "It was promised long ago. It comes to us through Jesus, the Messiah. You crucified Him, but God brought Him back to life." "What should we do?" the people asked sadly. "Turn away from evil," said Peter. "Believe in Jesus Christ. He will forgive your sins and give you His Holy Spirit." On that day, 3,000 people were baptized. They were just the first of many people who had come to trust in Jesus as their Savior.
Wow! God's Holy Spirit came and lived inside of all of Jesus' followers.
God's Holy Spirit gave them power to do things they never did before.
Yeah, but that happened a long time ago. Can God's Holy Spirit come and live inside of us and give us power too?
God's Holy Spirit can still live inside of us. I know He lives inside of me. God's Holy Spirit gives me power!
That's the answer, Shine! Did you hear that, friends?
How about I say the question and you can say the answer? Why does God's Holy Spirit live in you?
God's Holy Spirit gives me power!
Well, I'm off to play with Blinky.
And I need to visit Guy the Bible Guy. See ya, Shine! Let's go!
That must be Emily. Come in!
Hi, Guy! My friends and I are on a Bible adventure! Oh,
what are you trying to find out?
Well, we want to understand the question, why does God's Holy Spirit live in you?
I know! God's Holy Spirit gives me power.
That's the answer. We saw a story where God's people got all filled up with the Holy Spirit back in Bible times. Can God's Holy Spirit fill me up too?
When you choose to make Jesus the leader in your life, God's Holy Spirit fills your spirit. I was just reading that very same story in my Bible. God gave his followers something amazing.
Wait, I packed something in my bag about that. Friends, it's something special you get on your birthday.
Right! God's Holy Spirit is a wonderful gift. A special present from God to live in you when you choose to follow Jesus.
I remember doing that. I asked Jesus to take all the sin and wrong choices out of my heart. Is that when God's Holy Spirit came to live inside of me?
Yes, it was the same thing for me. And now God's Holy Spirit gives me power.
Yowza palooza! That is a God-sized gift.
Friends, wiggle your ears if you want to learn a verse about it. Okay, here goes. Romans 15, 19. He has given me the power of the Holy Spirit. Whoosh!
Oh, that's fun! Let's repeat it.
Romans 15, 19.
Romans 15, 19.
He has
given me
the power of the Holy Spirit. Whoosh!
Of the Holy Spirit. Whoosh!
Good job, friends. Now let's do it all together.
Romans 15, 19. He has given me the power of the Holy Spirit. Whoosh!
God's Holy Spirit really does live in me. He gives me the power to live just like Jesus. I can do what God wants for me because of his power. Thanks for teaching us, Guy.
I'm happy to teach you what God says in my favorite book, the Bible. Bye, Emily.
Bye, Guy.
Bye, friends. Ooh.
Okay, so we know the verse and the answer to the question, why does God's Holy Spirit live in you? Answer with me, friends. God's Holy Spirit gives me power. Great. Well, Mr. Music is pretty smart. I bet he'll know a song that will help us on our Bible adventure. Come on.
It's open.
Hey, Mr. Music. I hope I didn't interrupt you.
Hey, Emily. The only thing that makes me happier than worshiping God with music is worshiping God with friends.
My friends and I are on a Bible adventure. We're trying to understand the question, why does God's Holy Spirit live in you?
Well, I know the answer. God's Holy Spirit gives me power.
Yes! Guy, the Bible guy, gave us a Bible verse that says it this way. Romans 15, 19. He has given me the power of the Holy Spirit. Whoosh! But Mr. Music, it seems kind of weird that such a great big God can fit inside of me. I mean, isn't he crowded in there? And how can he fit in all of us at once?
When I was a kid, I had the same questions. I found out that when the Bible talks about my heart, it doesn't mean the thing inside my chest that goes bum bum, bum bum.
Well, what kind of heart does the Bible mean?
It means a spirit kind of heart. It's like this. God is a spirit. We can't see him with our eyes.
Oh, he's way too big to see.
God made people like him. We are a spirit you can't see too.
Poppin' puppies! God has made each one of us with a spirit made especially for God's Holy Spirit to live in. The Holy Spirit is with us wherever we go. He has given us the same power Jesus had so we can make the right choices.
God's Holy Spirit has a special spirit home inside of us.
That reminds me of something.
Or somewhere?
Somewhere you can live! What is it, friends? A house! My heart is a house for the Holy Spirit to live in. He comforts me, and he makes me feel brave when I feel afraid.
You know, God's Holy Spirit gives me songs to sing to him. Clap your hands together if you'd like to learn a new song about how the Holy Spirit gives us power.
Clap with me, friends.
Okay, sounds like you're ready. Here we go. When I get sad, when I get scared, when it gets hard to do the right thing, I know I'm never alone. I am not on my own. The Holy Spirit gives me power. Here we go. God's Spirit lives in me. His power lives in me.
God's Spirit lives in me. His power lives in me.
God's Spirit lives in me. His power lives in me.
God's Spirit lives in me. His power lives in me.
That was great.
Yeah, let's do it again.
Okay. When I get hurt, when I get mad, when it gets tough for me to obey, I know I'm never alone. I am not on my own. The Holy Spirit gives me power. Here we go. God's Spirit lives in me. His power lives in me.
God's Spirit lives in me. His power lives in me.
God's Spirit lives in me. His power lives in me.
God's Spirit lives in me. His power lives in me.
That was so much fun.
That was fun.
Now let's spend some more time worshiping God with music, singing, and dancing.
Oh, dancing! Hi, Shine.
Hi, Emily. Have you and our friends had a great Bible adventure?
Did we have a great Bible adventure? Yes!
Sounds like it was fun.
It was fun. We learned the answer to the question. Will you help me tell Shine the answer?
Okay, friends, why does God's Holy Spirit live in you?
God's Holy Spirit gives me power! We learned that God's Holy Spirit is a gift to us, and that my heart becomes a house for God's Holy Spirit to live in when I've asked Jesus to be the leader of my life.
Do you have a picture pass left?
Yes. It's something you can see yourself in. What is it, friends? The mirror! Shine, God's Holy Spirit changes me, but when I look in the mirror, I don't look any different.
He doesn't change your outside. He changes your spirit kind of heart on the inside. So you look more like Jesus in the way you act.
Yuppie guppy! Oh, he's there to comfort me when I'm sad. And he makes me brave when I'm afraid.
When God's Holy Spirit lives in you, he gives you the power to live like Jesus.
I wish I could see that in a mirror.
You can't see your spirit heart, but God can see it. He loves looking at your heart when the Holy Spirit lives there.
Shine, we learned a verse about that.
Let's all say it together.
Romans 15:19. He has given me the power of the Holy Spirit. Whoosh.
Emily, I want God's Holy Spirit to live in all of our friends. Can we pray about that together before it's time to go?
Okay, let's bow our heads and close our eyes. We're gonna talk to God together. God, thank you for the wonderful gift of your Holy Spirit. Please fill our friends with your power as they learn to trust you with their whole hearts. Give them the power to live like Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Sweet sassy molasses, it's time to go. We'll see you next time
for another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye!
Thank you all so much for joining us this month on the Church Kids Show as we learned all about who God is.
We hope that you know that God is so much more than just someone sitting up in heaven far away looking down on the world.
Yeah, with a beard. He doesn't have, Amy might have a beard, I don't know. He created you, he loves you, and he wants a relationship with you.
We'll see you next week to start our new series all about God's son, Jesus.
See you next week. And don't forget, it's a great day
to be a church kid. Woo! Yeah! The Church Kids Show.